My name is Katie Bouman, and I am currently a postdoc with the Event Horizon Telescope. I've seen the images for a while, but being able to share it with you all today has been spectacular. This is just like kind of the beginning of being able to have another window into what black holes can tell us about our laws and physics. But already we've learned so much. So, you know, we didn't know, even though we had predicted that if you had a black hole that you would see this ring of light, we didn't know we were going to get that ring of light. And that's, you know, what we were kind of testing. We could have gotten just a blob. And so seeing that ring and seeing a ring that has a size that is consistent with other measurements that have been done completely differently, I think that in itself is amazing and stronger proof for black holes than so many other tests that have been done before. It's the first time we actually can see the environment right next to a black hole, the environment of a black hole. And so that in itself, I think, just being able to see that ring of light, being able to see that that ring exists is huge. Probably the biggest thing that we've done. But then there's also all the things about what that ring tells us. The asymmetry and how it's brighter on the bottom than the top tells us about how gas is flowing around it, that it's on the bottom, that gas is coming more towards us and it's Doppler boosted and brighter because of that. And then eventually we want to be able to also figure out, you know, what do these pictures tell us about the accretion, how matter accretes into the black hole, and how it's connected to jet launching, and how these huge, you know, galactic scale jets, you know, are shooting out of this black hole. So moving forward, what I'm interested in is figuring out the next step of how do we put a new telescope, where do we place a new telescope on the Earth? Or how do we put in, what orbit should we put for a telescope in space that allows us to sharpen this picture even more? And simultaneously, we can't just independently decide what we want to put a telescope here or there. We should do it at the same time as developing algorithms that tell us, oh, for this algorithm, this would be the best locations. Or simultaneously, and by doing those together, you can get the best results. So I'm really excited for the future of this, of developing the techniques necessary to expand our array, to expand our algorithms, to get a sharper picture and learn more.